I don't need to do this. I don't really want to do this, but I'm a fan of the show. I love watching it. There's something incredibly edge of the seat about watching someone you know doing things you never expected and hopefully watching them fail.
Come to think of it, I think I'm the biggest bogan I know.
I've lived a fairly glossy life, you know. I wear nice suits on Family Feud and have a game show smile. So I'm kind of looking forward to getting a little bit gritty and uncomfortable and scared.
So I hear you saying he's a television guy. What kind of a farmer could he be? Like, how serious of a farmer is he? Got the hat. Totally legit. Check it out, Australia. Drinking in a little bit. That's right. All the gear and no idea. Come on, I'll show you around inside.
I'm nervous about going in. I've done a lot of crazy stuff in my life, but I've seen this show, man. I've seen what it does to people. I've seen what it does to celebrities. And it's all about humiliation and harming our self-confidence. And self-confidence is all our celebrities have. So I'm packing my dacks.
So we live on a farm in Bathurst, central west of New South Wales. I'm a motor racing man. I love it.
That's Mount Panorama right there. It's literally my spiritual home. I feel very magnetically drawn to this place because I love motor racing so much, and I've done 3 Bathurst 1000s and a heap of 12-hour races. So.
But not only that, just farm life is good. We make a lot of television in high intensity. Sometimes you can make like game show episodes and you can do 30 in about 72 hours. So it's good to come back here, unplug, breathe in the fresh air, just let the body slow down a little bit and, you know, reconnect with Earth. So we love where we live. It's pretty special.
My kids love watching the show. So I think it'd be nice for them to think that Dad's doing a really cool thing. Gee, I hope he'll come home. If I think of my kids and my wife, I think that'll only make me miss home more, and that'll make each day longer and harder. So I think I'm going to have to try and block it out as much as I can so I can focus on what I am trying to do there. And then if I get to a point where it's really, really tough and I feel like breaking, I think that that's when I'll think of them and think of their love and their smiles and how proud they might be. And I think that'll be the extra push to sort of get me over the line when things get really, really tough. Because, you know, that's, if I'm not doing it for them, what am I doing anything for? My wife will miss me because she has to do everything by herself, and that's not easy because she's well up the duff. She's properly pregnant, so she's about to burst. I know she's going to be cursing me a lot while I'm in there, and thankfully I can't hear her, so that's a good thing. But I'm going in with her blessing. And just coming back for the arrival of the child. Yay, father of the year. Woo! What a husband.
Look at all of those. Did you pick all of those?
Yeah.
Well done, in your ballet outfit. You want to just take the apple and not the rest of the tree? Good job, darling.
I am worried as hell that Chris and Julia, because they do know them, will use me as an example to push the envelope. And because they know me, they feel like they can probably do it to me rather than someone they don't know. So I have a fear that I'll be given the worst challenges in the worst circumstances, in the worst scenarios, and they will think it's hilarious. Look what he did to bloody Miguel when Miguel's in the friggin' lake and he sends out a robotic crocodile out to attack him, and Miguel thought he was about to die, and he gives this crocodile like this almighty sort of punch to try and save himself, and then to find out that it wasn't even real. You can't do that to someone. That's not right. They're gonna do that to me because they go, oh, we're friends. Nah, after this I bet you we won't be. I bet you 100% we won't be.
And we come in and What is that? Oh, man. Oh, this old thing?
Look, my life has been working on a stage with contestants coming and going, and all of them different personalities. And I like to make them all feel welcome and comfortable and as normal as possible so they can have the time of their life. That's the way I operate. But if someone wants to come on and wants to own me, and push me around. I don't dig bullies. And one of my great regrets is not stepping in and saying, stop, that's not acceptable. If someone starts throwing their weight around and belittling others, you know, I don't like that. I can't handle that. So I think that's when Grant puts on his big boy pants and becomes a man.
Check out my pride and joy. If I could be mowing every second of the day, I'd be the happiest man on earth. It's like meditation to me, but just look how luscious and green it is.
Miss my lawnmower. I like mowing lawns. I need that in my life. I'm going to have to learn somehow to slow it down. Give myself a bit of a talking to. Try and keep the enthusiasm up and the, you know, the self-talk. Try and keep it positive rather than negative. So I'll miss my lawnmower for that reason. But of course, you know, my kids, I can't live without someone coming in to wake me up in the morning and climbing on the bed saying, I love you, and giving you a cuddle. And that is the best possible start to any day, you know. I don't want to be lying next to some snoring behemoth and be that my only experience of waking up every day. So I'm going to do it for the kids, you know. I know that they'd be proud of me in there, and that'll sort of get me through, but it ain't going to be easy. I'm not a leader, but I'm not a follower either. I'm a mediator, I reckon, because there's going to be times of conflict. There's going to be times of uncomfortable conversations and moodiness. And I think I'm like Switzerland. I'm not that side or that side, but I think I can bring harmony to the camp, hopefully. For me, it would be a success if I just went in there. I tried my hardest. I tried to lift the mood of my fellow campmates. And if there's a point where one of them is frozen, they can't go on, maybe the fear has overcome them and they're stopped in their tracks and they think they want to leave and it's all over. You know, I just want to be the bloke there who encourages them, gives them a hand, pulls them up, inspires them to let them know that they can do this, and just watch the relief and the satisfaction when they've done something that they thought was impossible. I reckon that'd be a really special moment and a really bonding experience. So, yeah, sometimes as a group, when you work collectively together, you can achieve incredible things. And yeah, that's the kind of environment I'd like to be a part of.
Okay, here we go. Packing. Packing for a holiday is exciting. This is not a holiday. Lots of undies. In this side, I tend to put my toiletries. What are you doing in there?
I'm having a little dad.
Who put you in there?
Me. I wanted her to leave.